Welcome back to the Red Boar. I'm Laura. Today I am going to be painting another Bob Ross out of this book. So I will be painting Deep Forest Lake. If you want in watercolor, let's start with that. In watercolor, it's going to be in watercolor. And if you're interested in seeing that, stick around. Welcome back. Hi. Welcome back. We are going to be working on the Bob Ross book again. We are going to be doing Deep Forest Lake. There we go. Deep Forest Lake. The reason why this back of the paper is messy, I started this, started recording it, and I'm not 100% happy with it. So I'm just going to try this again. This time a little bit better. Take two. I won't say take one. But just be honest with all of you. So we're going to start that, and yeah. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to be doing the background. We are going to be making the base for the leaves and painting this mostly black. Let's get started. Welcome back. This is mostly dry. So the next step we are going to do is I'm going to add like a little blue green to this section, the kind of dotted out sections over. So I'm going to be doing that. Let's get into it. Welcome back. Now that this is dry, we are going to be doing filling in this part with white and a little red and a little yellow to kind of make a nice little sky. So let's get into it. Thank you. All right, now that this is dried, I'm gonna take a mixture of green, blue, and brown and just kind of blotting out all of the basic shapes. Kind of go over this a little bit too. Now we are going, instead of using a brush start, I'm using my watercolor pencil to give me more fine lines to do the trees, the branches and all that. So. Now I'm going to take some water and just go over it. So I'm going to be making the trees with a lighter green and yellows, oranges and reds. So I'm going to get started on that. Welcome back. We are going to start on the water now. So we're just going to start with adding a little white over here. So let's get into it. Welcome back. I'm going to be adding highlights to the water's edge and then adding a little blue and a little white to create more water effect here, and maybe adding a little low lights too, seeing how well that works to the water's edge to kind of make it pop. Let's get started. I'm going to add some white ripples around the rock's edge and then kind of work on the water a little bit more. So I'm going to break it into that. Thank you. back. But now we're going to be doing the middle ground of the panning. We're going to start by taking a mixture of green, blue, and brown, and just doing the underlying layer of the bushes. We're now going to highlight the bushes here, so I'm going to get started on that. Alright, we are going to add the water coming in this way. So I'm going to start on that. We're going to start by working on the base rocks around this land formation, and then I'm going to darken a little bit of this too. So I'm going to get started with that. Thank you. Welcome back. I'm going to be adding some dimension to the rocks over here, and then I'm going to start adding some tree lines up in this area. Let's get to it. Alright, now I'm going to be adding some black to the rocks just to give them a little more dimension here. And then I'm going to be adding white highlights to the branches up here. Alright, I'm going to be adding foliage over here on this tree, and I'm going to be adding smaller little tree trunks on this side, and then starting on the foreground over here too. Thank you. I'm going to now add highlights to this area on these tree trunks before I go working on the foreground. Now I'm going to add foliage over here and then work on the highlights over here. I'm going to now be adding highlights to the trees up here and then to the underbrush. Alright, next I'm going to be adding a large tree trunk right over here. And I'm going to do the base rocks here and here. Going to now add white to highlight the rocks and make them more rock-like. I'm going to now add highlights to the tree trunk. Alright, I'm now going to be adding water down this way and then adding greenery around the tree trunk and then onto this rock. How much you guys saw or heard, but what I have done is I took some yellow and highlighted the bushes and pretty much all over to lighten it again, and then I took more black and I put it all up here, and I'm just adding white in around for like ripples. Thank you. Alright, this is it. Now I'll show you what the picture looks like in the book in a second. The camera's looking a little bit. There it is. I'm pretty happy with it. And then I'll show you what the picture looks like in the book. And that's it. My camera's lagging a little bit. Yeah. So the book and then what I did. So. Oh my gosh, can't. That's it. Talk to you soon. That's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. It was a fun video to make. If you liked the video, please like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you next time. Bye!